brought to you by WikiVD Documentaries. Hugo Film. Hugo is a 2011 historical adventure drama film directed and co-produced by Martin Scorsese and adapted for the screen by John Logan. Based on Brian Selznick's book The Invention of Hugo Cabret, it is about a boy who lives alone in the Gare Montparnasse railway station in Paris in the 1930s. A co-production between Graham King's GK Films and Johnny Depp's Infinitum Nihil. The film stars Ben Kingsley, Sacha Baron Cohen, Asa Butterfield, Chloe Grace Moretz, Ray Winston, Emily Mortimer, Jude Law, Helen McCrory, and Christopher Lee. Hugo is Scorsese's first film shot in 3D, of which the filmmaker remarked, "I found 3D to be really interesting, because the actors were more upfront emotionally. Their slightest move, their slightest intention is picked up much more precisely." The film was released in the United States on November 23, 2011. When it was released, Hugo received critical acclaim and received 11 Academy Award nominations, more than any other film that year, and won 5 awards: Best Cinematography, Best Art Direction, Best Sound Mixing, Best Sound Editing, and Best Visual Effects. It was also nominated for 8 BAFTAs, winning 2, and was nominated for 3 Golden Globe Awards, earning Scorsese his 3rd Golden Globe Award for Best Director. The film grossed a dismal $185 million against a budget of $170 million. Plot. In 1931, 12-year-old Hugo Cabret lives in Paris with his father, a kind but widowed clockmaker who also works part-time at a museum. One day, his father finds a broken automaton, a mechanical man designed to write with a pen, at the museum. And Hugo and he try to repair it, his father documenting the automaton in a notebook. When his father is killed by a fire at the museum, Hugo is forced to live with his resentful alcoholic Uncle Claude, and made to learn how to maintain the clocks at the railway station of Gare Montparnasse. When Claude goes missing for several days, Hugo continues to maintain the clocks, fearing that he would be sent away as an orphan by the vindictive station inspector Gustave if Claude's absence is discovered. Hugo attempts to repair the automaton with stolen parts, believing it contains a message from his father. But the machine still requires a heart-shaped key that his father could not find. Hugo is caught when stealing from the toy store owner Georges, who looks through his father's notebook and threatens to destroy it. Hugo encounters Georges' goddaughter Isabelle, who offers to help get the notebook back. Hugo learns Georges has forbidden Isabelle from going to the cinema, and introduces the medium to her as his father had done for him. As their friendship grows, he shows her the automaton, and is astonished when Isabelle inadvertently reveals she wears the key as a necklace given to her by Georges. When started, the machine draws out a scene that Hugo recognizes from his father's description of the film A Trip to the Moon. Isabelle identifies the signature, that of a Georges Méliès, as her godfather. She sneaks Hugo into her home, where they find a hidden cache of more imaginative drawings of Méliès, but are caught by Georges, who banishes Hugo from his home. Hugo and Isabelle go to the Film Academy library and find a book about the history of cinema that praises Méliès' contributions. They meet the book's author, René Tabard, a film expert who is surprised to hear that Méliès might still be alive, as he had disappeared after World War I along with nearly all copies of his films. Excited at the chance to meet him, René agrees to meet Isabelle and Hugo at Georges's home to show his copy of A Trip to the Moon, hoping it will invigorate Georges. On the scheduled night, George's wife Jean tries to turn them away, but Rene compliments Jean as Jean Dalcy, an actress in many of Melly's films, and she allows them to continue. As the film plays, Georges wakes up at the sight, and Jean finally convinces him to cherish his accomplishments rather than regret his lost dream. Georges recounts that as a stage magician, he had been fascinated by motion pictures and used the medium to create imaginative works through his Star Film Company, but was forced into bankruptcy following the war, closing his studio and selling his films to be turned into raw materials. He laments that even an automaton he made that he donated to a museum was lost. Hugo recognizes this is the same automaton he has, and races to the station to retrieve it. He is caught by Gustave, who has learned that Claude's body was found some time ago, and threatens to take Hugo to the orphanage. Georges arrives and tells Gustave that he will now see to Hugo, adopting him as his son. Some time later, Georges is named a professor at the Film Academy, and is paid tribute through a showcase of his films recovered by René. Hugo joins in with his new family as they celebrate at the apartment, where the guests include a mellower Gustave who is clearly in love with Lisette from the patisserie. As the movie ends, Isabelle starts to write down Hugo's story. Pre-production. GK Films acquired the screen rights to The Invention of Hugo Cabret shortly after the book was published in 2007. Initially, Chris Wedge was signed in to direct the adaptation and John Logan was contracted to write the screenplay. The film was initially titled Hugo Cabret. Several actors were hired, including Ben Kingsley, Sacha Baron Cohen, Asa Butterfield, Chloe Grace Moretz, and Helen McCrory, Jude Law, Ray Winston, Christopher Lee, Francis de la Tour, and Richard Griffiths later joined the project. Hugo was originally budgeted at $100 million, but ran over with a final budget between $156 million and $170 million. In February 2012, Graham King summed up his experience of producing Hugo. "Let's just say that it hasn't been an easy few months. For me, there's been a lot of Ambien involved. Thank you for watching. Brought to you by WikiVD Documentaries. Please like and subscribe below."